It's going to be a season of great music starting in September. And you can secure your seats by subscribing tonight at the subscription services table on the fifth floor. Or you can visit our website at jalc.org for more information. Great music tonight, the music of the master, the one, the only, Duke Ellington. Please welcome. Please welcome the Jazz and Lincoln Center Orchestra with Wynton Marsalis.
Y'all hollering for Joe. You're gonna get a good dose of Joe tonight. Duke Ellington is perpetually modern. Tonight we're gonna play music written after the Second World War to the early 70s. In 1963, the U.S. State Department brought Ellington and his famous orchestra to Egypt, India, Iraq, Jordan, Lebanon, Pakistan, Persia, which is now Iran, and Turkey, amongst other places. In 64, the orchestra toured Japan. Duke and Billy Strayhorn, his co-composer, were inspired by these experiences to write the Far East Suite, even though they were really in the Middle and Near East. It was recorded in 1966. And on these tours, Ellington took in all the sights and sounds. We're gonna begin with the opening piece of the Far East Suite entitled Tourist Point of View, of which Duke wrote, "The smells of spices and garlic and exotic perfumes. There are marvelous brocades, oriental rugs, glass and copper trays, inlaid and engraved. The cats in the band go crazy about everything they see." This features Walter Blanding on the tenor saxophone, Tourist Point of View.
Thank you.
Welcome, Blanding. Welcome, Blanding. January 21st, 1951, Duke premiered two pieces at the Metropolitan Opera House. One of them was the controversial suite. It was a two-movement work that Ellington wrote to answer the traditionalist versus progressive debate that seems to always engage jazz aficionados, or really just aficionados in general. Duke, of course, took both sides. The first movement, entitled Before My Time, references New Orleans music instrumentation, and it even draws from a piece that's on the first ever jazz recording, entitled Tiger Rag. The second, entitled Later, refers to some of the stylistic choices of Stan Kenton, employing jarring dissonances, a heavier sense of swing, and often bombastic and a lot of fun horn work. This is entitled Later. We hope you enjoy it. Thank you. Jackson, Dan Nimmer, Walter Blanding, Carlos Enriquez, in 1958, Duke met Queen Elizabeth II, who is still queen, at a private reception. The meeting inspired him to dedicate a piece to her. The next year, he made one pressing of a piece called The Queen's Suite, and he sent it directly to Buckingham Palace. This suite, one of Ellington's most beautiful works, remained hidden from the public until after his death, and then it was released in 1976. In his autobiography, Music is My Mistress, Duke writes about getting lost on the south shore of the Ohio River, searching for a country club where they were to play a gig. On a back road, they encountered a cadre of, I think that's how you pronounce that, cadre. That's a tricky word, cadre, something like that. Of lightning bugs dancing, anyway, there was a lot of them together. They were dancing in the air while a chorus of frogs croaked in a gully below. This scene inspired the second movement of the Queen's Suite, and that movement is entitled Lightning Bugs and Frogs. Victor Goins, Chris Crenshaw, Carlos Enriquez. This next piece conjures up images of a deserted border town, with the clarinet, trumpet, and plunger trombone interjections. Those are the New Orleans frontline instruments. They act as the spirits of those long departed, or some type of spirit. It was recorded on the futuristic album Afrobossa, a 1963 release on Frank Sinatra's Reprise label. It's one of the greatest albums of all times. Unrecognized, so much great music on each track. This is entitled Bunga, Empty Town Blues. It's the subtitle. We hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. Marcus Printup, Kenny Rampton, Sherman Irby, Ted Nash, Victor Goins, Elliot Mason,
thank you very, very much. I would like to play a song from the soundtrack of Paris Blues, which was a United Artists 1961 film starring Sidney Poitier and Paul Newman as musicians living in Paris, and Diane Carroll and Joanne Woodward as two vacationing American tourists who just happened to be beautiful and also there. So you know what happened. That happened and continued to happen, but a lot of great music was also played. This piece entitled Paris Stairs is a rare jazz waltz, and it shows Duke a combination of absolute earthiness and complete sophistication. Paris Stairs. Thank you.
Marcus Prenup, Dan Nimmer, the saxophone section, Victor Goins on the clarinet.
Austrian film director Otto Preminger asked Ellington to compose the music for his 1959 film, Anatomy of a Murder. And Ellington prepared his first score for a motion picture in nearly 25 years and his first ever for a full-length feature film. He established a small handful of themes that appear in multiple songs. And Duke managed to create a unified vision for the music. At the same time, he stunned everybody with the sheer range of timbral possibilities that the big band could produce. He was the master of color. This selection uses two themes. Its first portion, Ellington called Merrily Rolling Along, but it's not merry at all because it's in 6/8 and 3/4 at the same time. And the second theme, Polly, is a mysterious, sultry melody that will appear in 4/4 time. Merrily Rolling Along will be played by Joe, and Polly will be played by Walter, and the rest of us will hang on. This is entitled Hero to Zero.
Joe Temple, Walter Blanding, Carlos Enriquez,
the final piece on this half is an imaginatively engineered minor blues. It's something that the maestro did throughout his entire career. A lot of people, we talk about the blues and we think about Muddy Waters and Howlin' Wolf and Son House and on and on and on. But the real true master of the blues is Duke Ellington. Duke once said, I dress the blues up in their Sunday best. Uh-oh. That might be the blues right there. There's some blues. Joe Williams, a great singer with the Count Basie Orchestra, told me that whenever Duke would come to hear the band, the Basie band, they would play and they would wait for him to get his coat. And whenever he got his coat and went to the door, they immediately launched into some blues. And they said that they knew he would always come back and sit down. And he did. This piece uses introspective ruminations on the piano and the clarinet to open and close various sections. It's originally written for Jimmy Hamilton, phenomenal clarinetist who was in the very first original Jazz at Lincoln Center Orchestra when we tried to put it back together. And our whole program is founded on the spirit and the music of Duke Ellington. It's such a great honor to play his music. And many of us, the younger of us, learned how to play in big bands playing his music and in this orchestra. And we have an Ellingtonian here with us still, Mr. Joe Temperley. But the first orchestra, give Joe something. He didn't hear me. Joe stopped listening to me years ago. This, he's heard it all. This is gonna feature Mr. Victor Goins on the clarinet and Dan Nimmer on the piano. It's entitled Ad Lib on Nippon.
Thank you.
Victor Goins. Victor Goins on the clarinet. Victor Goins. Dan Nimmer on the piano. Dan Nimmer. Carlos Enriquez on the bass. Carlos Enriquez. Ali Jackson on the drums. We are the Jazz at Lincoln Center Orchestra. Thank you very, very much. We're going to take a little 15-minute pause and we will be right back. Thank you so much.